I think there's really two main reasons why there's so much excitement for CAR T cells. And the first is that for literally decades, developing immune therapy has been considered the holy grail of cancer therapeutics. It's something that I remember being taught back in medical school had the power to really change the landscape of cancer therapy. And CAR T cells are the culmination of that 30 years or so of research. And to see it come to fruition and be available for patients is really a huge advance. The second reason is because of the results. So in the diseases that we're using it for, and primarily in the disease that I'm most interested in, which is childhood ALL, the response rates where 90% of patients go into a deep remission and potentially 60% of patients can be cured with this therapy is just amazing given the fact that those patients were simply out of standard options before this therapy came along. At this point, there's two main groups of patients that are candidates for CAR T cells. One are children and young adults with B lineage ALL, and the other are adults with an aggressive form of B lineage lymphoma. And as it stands now, patients with both of these diseases are eligible only if they've failed upfront therapy, if their disease has relapsed or it hasn't responded to upfront therapy. So the process starts by identifying an appropriate patient for the therapy. And then the first step in the management of the patient is to have them come to Johns Hopkins to undergo what's called apheresis. And that's where we collect the patient's own T cells. At that point, those T cells are shipped off to the manufacturing facility to create the CAR T cell product. That takes anywhere from 3 to 4 weeks on average. And during that time, we typically will have the patient receive bridging therapy, and that's therapy designed to keep their leukemia or lymphoma kind of at bay, if you will, before their CAR T-cell product is ready for us to infuse. We receive the product back from the manufacturing facility, and that it comes back cryopreserved or frozen, and then we bring it to the patient's bedside, thaw it, and infuse the product at that point. The 4 or 5 days before we infuse the product, we give the patient a little bit of conditioning chemotherapy to make the patient's body ready to receive the T cells, if you will. And then we follow the patient very closely for the next month, which is when the first evaluation occurs. The process is very much a collaboration between the referring hospital physician and Johns Hopkins. Really, the only two parts of that process where the patient really needs to be at Johns Hopkins or in the immediate vicinity are the 1 to 2 days required to collect the T cells, and then the probably 4 to 5 weeks that span the actual infusion of the CAR T cells. The remainder of the time, we can work with the local referring physician and hospital to provide therapy for the patient and follow up after they receive their CAR T cells. The two main risks of CAR T cells are a condition called cytokine release syndrome, or CRS, and neurotoxicity. The timing of these two side effects is different. The cytokine release syndrome, the risk for that, is really any time from about 1 day after the CAR T cells are infused to about a week after, so in that first week after receiving the therapy. And the neurotoxicity, the timing is a little bit later. It can be as long as a few weeks after, or even longer after receiving the CAR T cells. The cytokine release syndrome is due to the activation of the patient's T cells after they're given back to the patient. And so what happens there is the T cells, when they get activated, release chemicals called cytokines. And those cytokines cause symptoms like fever, low blood pressure, difficulty breathing, difficulty handling fluid, and fluid leaking basically in the body. And that's the cytokine release syndrome side effect. The neurotoxicity is probably also caused by the release of cytokines, but it occurs later and it affects the function of the brain. And the two main side effects that one can see are what we call encephalopathic symptoms, and these would be things like confusion, not being able to speak properly. And then the other is seizures, so we give seizure preventative medications. Fortunately, both cytokine release syndrome and neurotoxicity are, in virtually all cases, 100% reversible, and patients go back to their baseline after they've received that. Now, this is a distinct pattern of toxicity compared to the alternative treatments in this situation, like intensive chemotherapy or transplant. So the cytokine release syndrome neurotoxicity are unique. They occur relatively early and they fully resolve, whereas chemotherapy and transplant can have prolonged side effects. And so we really think there may be an advantage to CAR T cells in that way. And then the final thing to mention is that CAR T cells will eliminate normal B cells as well as tumor B cells. And so patients can be left without B cells for a long period of time. That's called B cell aplasia, and that can require immunoglobulin infusions for potentially life after patients receive this therapy. Unfortunately, no. Like most therapies, or all therapies to date, they don't work in every patient. And there's two main reasons why CAR T cells currently are not working. For about 10% of patients, the T cells simply don't expand and don't engraft in the patient after they're infused. And then in another 30% of patients, they engraft and the patient responds. But then some period of time later, usually within several months, the patient's leukemia comes back, usually because it has learned and adapted and now no longer expresses the protein that the CAR T cells are targeted against, which is called CD19. That's called CD19 escape when that happens. So there's lots of work going on to optimize the CAR T cells to reduce both of those reasons that they don't work, to both reduce the rate of patients whose CAR T cells don't engraft after they're infused from 10% down hopefully to 0%, and also to modify the CAR T cells so that they can target more than one protein on the leukemia to prevent that CD19 escape that's occurring. They're very expensive. The current price tag for the CAR T cell products are anywhere from $350,000 to almost $500,000 for the treatment. So far, insurance companies have been reimbursing for the cost of the CAR T cells and been covering the CAR T cell cost, at least for the patients that are being treated in accordance with the FDA indications. The companies have also set up programs to help make sure that the treatment is affordable to as many patients as possible. So there are things like co-insurance payments and reimbursements. There's reimbursements for lodging and travel associated with having to go to a different center for CAR T cells. And there are programs where the CAR T cells are provided free of charge for patients that are indigent or uninsured. So hopefully, most patients can find a way to make these products affordable over time, but it's a concern moving forward that, you know, with therapies this expensive, that the system will be able to sustain providing them for patients. So we are one of approximately 40 or so centers that are able to offer this treatment to children and young adults. In our area, we're one of the only programs in the Mid-Atlantic. There's in Philadelphia is the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia program. There's us, and then I think the next one to the south of us is Duke. And then there's a couple to the west out once you get to the Midwest. So we cover a pretty large region of the United States and are taking referrals from that area. You know, the other thing is our children's center, I think, is one of the top children's centers for all of the different services that it takes to make CAR T cells a reality. So you have to have a very high functioning intensive care unit, cell therapy laboratory, the ability to do apheresis on site, physicians that are used to taking care of very sick patients with cellular therapy, and we have one of the best bone marrow transplant programs here. And we all work very closely and coordinate very closely to make sure the patient gets the very best care. So we're certainly not the only center that does CAR T cells, but I like to think we're one of the best, and I hope that patients feel that way when they come here for treatment.
Thank you.